classrooms allow teachers to set students' assignment, to collect in their work, and easily give them feedback. So here on the classrooms dashboard, I can go ahead and create a new classroom. Then click create. And then once I have a classroom, I can go to settings, and then on the users panel, I can add users, which will allow me to add students. So here we are as a student. So I can go ahead and click join classroom, and then here enter the code that is linked to the classroom given to me by my teacher and click join. And that is going to go ahead and add me to the classroom and launch me into the classroom dashboard here, where once there are assignments to see, the student will be able to see them. So back over here as a teacher now, I can see that the student that I just added appears in my dashboard in settings. So once you have all your students added, we can go ahead and create an assignment. So we can do that by clicking the new assignment button in the top right. And it's going to prompt us for a few things in order to create the assignment here. So it's going to ask us for a name, so I'll just do lesson one. And it's going to ask us for a due date, and this is when we want our students to complete the work by, and it will also help us later down the line of showing if students submitted the work on time or late. So if I just go ahead and set it for a week's time, and the description box is essentially the instructions that are going to be given to the student once they open the assignment in the editor. So if I just type in some text here, so lesson one, and I can format it to make the text bigger if I want to. And then have some smaller text there, and I can also insert images of something that relates to the assignment. I can also insert videos from YouTube or something like that, and also insert links to documents as well. So once we've kind of given our instructions, we set some starter project code. So what a starter project is essentially the code that is going to be loaded into the editor once the students open the assignment. So you can see that we have three options here of a new starter project, clone existing, and clone example. New project will create a blank project with a mode of the one that you choose, and also the type as well. Clone existing is going to give us a list of all the projects that are associated with my EduBlocks account. And clone example is a list of example starter projects if you want ideas and stuff like that. So we'll create a blank Python 3 blocks project here for this assignment and click create. And that is going to then appear on my teacher dashboard here. I can also kind of use this menu to edit the assignment if I want to change the details that I just inputted. And also this is where I can edit the starter project. So if I go into here, you can see that we have a blank starter project with no code in it. So to kind of just build the starter project out to give students a head start, I'll just go ahead and create a project here of a variable called name, set it to input, and I will add a print statement here. So that's kind of like my starter project, and what I want my students to do, which I could have explained in the instructions, is essentially get the variable to print, so they would be changing this text here. I can go ahead and save the start project and then return back to the assignments dashboard here. And that is our assignment complete. So let's go ahead and look at what this looks like for students. So over here on the student dashboard, I can see that I now have a lesson one assignment to complete. So I can go ahead and click on that. And it's going to open the assignment in the editor. So we can see that there's a few things that are different about the editor once we're loading an assignment. So we can see that the student on the right here can see the instructions that we set to go along with the assignment. You can see our screenshot and the text that we wrote out. You can also see our starter code, starter project here. So our instructions would explain what to do, which in my case is get the variable to print, and I can switch over to the code view if I want to, and run that. Give it a quick test. You can see that all works. Once I'm happy with my code as a student, I can go ahead and click submit, and it's going to say you won't be able to make any changes to this project unless the student wants to unsubmit their work and make changes, and they kind of just need to confirm that and click submit. So once the student has submitted it, the dashboard for assignments kind of changes a little bit here. We can see that the student has submitted it on time, and I've just submitted it. And the student can also go ahead and open the project in a read-only mode if they want to kind of just see what their work was like for future reference. And at this point, it's waiting for the teacher to mark it. So when you select on the filters here at the top, in waiting to be marked, that's where the student can see all of the assignments that are waiting to be marked by their teacher. So back over here on my teacher dashboard, if I go into my list of assignments, I can see that lesson one now has one submissions for the assignment. So I can then go ahead and click on it, and it's going to bring up this view here where I'll be able to see all of the students that have started the work, and filter it at the top of not submitted. So these will be students that have not submitted the work, but they have started it. Submitted is those that have submitted it. We can filter it by students that have submitted on time or late. And we can also have this waiting to be marked view and see the ones that we've marked as well. So going in waiting to be marked, that will open up the student's code in read-only mode. And the editor is going to have a new sidebar panel that is on the left here. And this is going to allow you to have access to all of your marking tools. So this drop down here, we only have one student on this classroom, but it's going to allow you to see a list of all of the students that have started the work and quickly switch between them. So if I had another student here, I could click their name and it'll load up their project in the editor. This kind of section at the bottom here is kind of just the student's name, when they submitted it, and also the feedback section. So I can go ahead and run the student's code, give it a quick test, see that works all correct. And what I can do is just say, great work, or whatever you want to put. If you want to have a screenshot, you can do that here as well. And what you can do is you can set it as marked if you want to kind of just say to the student, yes, I've looked at this and I've given you feedback, and I can click save. Or you can also unsubmit the project and hand it back to the student for improvements and further work. But because I'm happy with this, I will add my feedback, say that it's marked, and click save here. You can see that the status has changed to marked, and it will say when I've marked it. So if I go back to my teacher dashboard, you can see that there's no waiting to be marked submissions anymore. And you can see that in marked, we can see that demo user, which is my student, was marked 13 seconds ago. So let's have a look at what this looks like from a student point of view once we've marked their work. So back over here on the student dashboard, if I go to marked, I can see that lesson one has now been marked by the teacher, and the student can click on the assignment, and it's going to bring up this pop-up here where they will be able to view the teacher's feedback. So you can see that the comments that we put have appeared here, and also the screenshot as well. And if the student wants to view their code again, they can use the drop down next to the assignment to either open my code or view feedback. So we'll go open my code, and then we'll be able to see it in read-only mode, the code that they submitted for this assignment.